Hello everybody, welcome to the channel SRS. This is Sumit Roy and we have already studied voltage series, voltage shunt, current series and current shunt. So this is the class for the final verdict. What we have understood from the voltage series, voltage shunt and current series, current shunt feedbacks. This is what we have found out, that is voltage and current are the elements, those are fed back. So they only deal with the output impedances. They do not have any effect over the input impedance. Similarly, series and shunt mixing are available at the input. So, they deal with input impedances. They do not have any effect over the output impedances. So, based on our earlier derived results, what we can see that if voltage is fed back, that is from the output side, if voltage is the element that is fed back, that will decrease the output impedance, and if current is fed back, that will increase the output impedance. Similarly, based on our earlier derivations, if series mixing is there at the input section, obviously if series mixing, it means voltage addition or subtraction. Voltages can be added or subtracted in series and current cannot be. So thus, if series or voltage mixing is there, if series or shunt mixing is there at the input section, and series means obviously voltage addition or subtraction. So voltage and current, shunt means obviously current mixing. If it is there, so based on our derived results, if voltage or series mixing is there at the input, it will increase the input impedance. Input impedance increases. And if shunt mixing is there, input impedance decreases. So based on this input and output impedances, if we prepare a master chart, that is ZIF and ZOF, we can write series, shunt, so for ZIF, again I'll write series and shunt. For ZIF and ZOF, that is for ZOF, if voltage is there and current is there. So I have not mentioned voltage and current, so I can comment only for the input section, that is series and shunt. If series is there, then ZIF will increase. If shunt is there, ZIF will decrease. If series is there, ZIF will increase. And if shunt is there, ZIF will decrease. Similarly, for ZOF, now I have to mention voltage or current. So, let it be voltage series, voltage shunt, and current series and current shunt. So, if voltage is there, that is fed back, then output impedance has to decrease. For voltage, ZOF has to decrease. For current, ZOF has to increase, and similarly ZOF has to increase. So this is the master chart that can be used for voltage series, voltage shunt, current series and current shunt. So, and AF, obviously AF stays same, that is A upon 1 plus A beta. It stays same for all the four. So this is all from the feedback part. Now we'll meet for the some numericals, some questions, and that is application of this concepts on BJT amplifiers, BJT based amplifiers. Till then, goodbye. Consider subscribing, and if there are any comments, please leave them on the comment box. I'll try to answer all of them as far as possible.